Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. A lot of you have requested an updated video on the Polar Alignment Assistant. For those of you that don't know, a couple of weeks ago KSTARS 3.5.2 was released, and there were a lot of improvements to the Polar Alignment Assistant. And in this video, I will show you the basic operations and how they have improved over the previous version. We'll quickly run through the wizard and the settings in the simulator, but then I'll switch to a screen recording of a real session so that you can see how the new tool behaves in a real-world scenario. You can still find the Polar Alignment Assistant here underneath the alignment module. Just as in the previous version, you can find the wizard here in the middle panel underneath the Polar Alignment tab. I'm not quite sure what to think about the colors. I like that they add a little bit of clarity, but I find the red words a little bit more difficult to read than the white words, but that might just be me. Also, later in the wizard, they've added a green and yellow text, and normally they are very easy to read, but I find it difficult to use them in combination with an app that I use to make my monitor show red light only when I'm using it in the field. Also, I just quickly wanted to show you that this legacy polar alignment tool is still available. This is probably not the polar alignment tool that you are used to in 3.5.1. This is even older than that, but it was also available in 3.5.1 and earlier. So the first part of the wizard looks pretty much the same. You can select how many degrees you want EKOS to rotate your mount. You can select the direction, and you can select the speed with which you want your mount to move. Now, let me just quickly adjust some exposure settings. We want to see the star show up in the screen recording. And then we can press start. And we are capturing our first image. Found the coordinates, and it's rotating the mount. So one thing that's different is EKOS doesn't show the polar error underneath the coordinates here anymore. It makes sense that it doesn't do it, but I used to look at it in 3.5.1, so I kind of got used to it. It already calculated the second image, and now it's rotating for the second time. I expect the third image to come in pretty quickly. All right, and here EKOS found a polar error of 51 arc minutes and 46 arc seconds. And immediately what I notice is EKOS displays the polar error on each individual axis. So in azimuth, it's about 48 arc minutes, and in altitude, it's about 18 arc minutes. That's really cool, and it's very important, because normally for each project, there is an acceptable misalignment. And there's an acceptable polar error for the total alignment, as well as an acceptable misalignment per axis. So it's very good to be able to see those numbers here immediately in the beginning of the wizard. Now, when we zoom out, we can see something new. As in the previous version, we have a red target icon and this magenta line that displays our total misalignment. What is new is we now have this green line and this yellow line. I believe the green line displays my azimuth error and the yellow line shows the altitude error. You can see that my azimuth error is larger than the altitude error, and this green line is longer than the yellow line, so that's what makes me think that. So now I need to find a bright star like we normally do. Let's just use this one here. Yeah, that's a good one. So now this star needs to end up in this target. And when I press next, EKOS will give me some helpful information. I can refresh like in the previous version, but I could. But it also gives me some instructions. It tells me to first adjust the altitude knob and move the star along the yellow line, and then the azimuth knobs to move the star over the green line. So let me just change the refresh rate and I'll start adjusting my knobs. Now, it makes a lot more sense to show you the rest of the process in a real-world scenario. So I'll quickly move through the polar alignment wizard, and you'll notice that since this is my real setup, I end up with a lot smaller polar error, a total of 4 arc minutes. And now you can actually see that I checked the update PA error button. That's another new setting that I didn't show you earlier. When you use it, you can see a live estimation of your new polar error per axis. And the star that you are trying to move towards your target is being highlighted on screen with a yellow circle. So that makes it a lot easier to follow it around. Now I am going to speed up the recording a little bit. My connection at the time was a little slow when I was recording this screen recording, and I can't imagine that you want to see me fool around for a couple of minutes. Yeah, here I actually bumped against my tripod, so I had to readjust my alignment. But fortunately, I could easily find my star back because of the yellow circle around it. So it takes a little longer than usual, but I'll get there. Yeah, I think this is good enough. Let's call it quits. You could have seen earlier that the polar misalignment is now under the 30 arc seconds. But let me do a double check. I'm now parking my mount and I'm unparking it. Now I'm doing the entire polar alignment assistant again. Only I'm not planning on adjusting my alignment. I just want to see what polar error it comes up with. So here you can see that it's already taking a second image. A third. There it is. A polar alignment error of 10 arc seconds. That is more than good enough for me. So I hope you found this video useful. If you did, consider giving it a like. I have a lot more videos coming up, so if you're interested in that, keep an eye on the channel. And as always, if you have any questions or want me to address a certain topic, just leave it in the comments below. So take care, and I hope to see you next time.